So each year I travel north in search of whitefish, and I target these fish with my steelhead outfit, my center pin reel, noodle rod, and some slip floats. And you can see how I do that on my solo trip vlog, day 5 to 7, I target whitefish, and they're an absolute blast to catch. But whitefish are abundant and they have generous limits, so they're a great fish if you want to harvest fish. They're great eating fresh, I really like them that way, but they don't freeze well, so I like to can them. And with their high omega-3 fatty content, they are an excellent choice for the canner and healthy for you. And so I'm going to show you how I do the canning process in this video. So to get this process started, we're going to can these whitefish in jars. So I've got them thawing in cold water. They're frozen this morning. They're almost ready to go. So yeah, so they're pretty much thawed out. I got my jars ready. I did them in the dishwasher, so they don't have to be sterilized, they just have to be nice and clean. They're going to get plenty sterilized during the pressure canning process, and I like to use the little jars, so I don't, some people use the big jars, I like the little ones. That's good for like two lunches for me, so that's perfect. I've got 9 fish there, so we'll pretty much use maybe 15 jars or so, we'll see. They're pretty big ones, so it might change. So rings are ready and brand new lids. Always use brand new lids. Never reuse your lids. Always just buy new ones. So those are ready. So I gotta get these fish all skinned and ready to go. So that's the next part of the process. So now the fish is all thawed out, I need to skin it. So you have to leave the skin on to transport the fish legally. Now legally I only have to leave like a little 1 or 2 inch patch on the fish to transport, just so if someone stops me they can count the number of fish and identify the species. I just leave all the skin on just to make it easy. So I just kind of cut down to the skin, knife at a 45 degree angle, and I pull the skin. I don't actually cut, I pull the skin. And then I flip it over. Now I don't know how well you can see all this. I did a pretty good job there, but I like to take off a lot of this mud line, or we call it a mud line, I don't know what you really call it, but it's this red dark meat along the middle. That's the stuff that's super fishy and kind of spoils it for you. You know, if you open a can of salmon, you see that really dark, dark meat in there. That's the what we call the mud line. So that's gone. One done. Do another one again. Just start at the end there, 45 degree angle. Get it started. And once you got enough, you can grab onto. Again, I just pull the fish. I hold the knife still at the 45 degree angle. And just pull the fish. So that one's got lots of mud line. So if you get too close to the skin, you get a lot of mud line. So you see how I've kind of pinched the middle? So I can just kind of cut out that stuff. You don't have to get every little speck of it off, but the more you get off, the better. So right there, you can really see how red that is. So yeah, if you just pinch it a little bit and get under there, and then you can get a lot of it. But again, I'm not gonna spend a lot of time being nitpicky about it. Just wanna get as much as I can. So yeah, there's one big fillet ready to go. So I will continue to do this. I think I had 9 fish out, so this will take me a little bit more. Pull the skin, hold the knife still, shake it back and forth, pinch the body. If you have a better way of doing this, just leave it in the comments because I'd love to know it. But this seems to work for me anyway. So another one ready to go. So I'll be back when I get those all done. So fillets are all done. Got a jar full in there. All the skin and stuff there. I'll go feed that to the coons. Not that I like coons, but they usually get into it. And the rest of the fillets are just in cold water there. So I am ready to get my jars all out and ready to go. So yeah, jars and lids. I always like to prepare more jars than I think I'm gonna need because yeah, you never know. And I mean, you can always use them another time, but yeah, it's always good to be prepared. I'm gonna take the fillets, I'm gonna chop them all up into chunks and pack them in the jars pretty tight. You put them in there pretty good, but leave a 1 inch head space. And you gotta leave that space for them to seal properly and expand properly and cook. So 1 inch head space, pack it in pretty tight. So I'm gonna do that now. So I got some on the go. I need more jars, and I always like to make sure I have far more jars than I think I'm gonna need. Just because, oh, it's probably pretty noisy, isn't it? Just because you never know. So I'm gonna make sure I have lots of jars ready there. Done. So I'm just about done. I just gotta finish up these last few fillets and we'll get cracking on cooking them down. So this last jar will just be little chunks, and that really doesn't matter. As long as you get the fish in there, it doesn't really matter if it's just chunks or what. So now all the jars are packed. I actually got 24 jars, which is pretty cool. I didn't think I'd get that many. So anyways, they're all ready to go right there. And so there is lots of different ways you can spice them and fix them all up. I know people put jalapeno peppers in them and hot sauce and liquid smoke, all these different things. I am just gonna do salt. That's all I do. I usually make like sandwich stuff for this. I mix it up with avocado and onion and pepper and stuff like that. So I don't put a lot of spice in it. I just wanna put salt in it. So I put in a small jar like that, probably, yeah, a quarter of a teaspoon of salt. Not very much, so we'll get that done now. So the next step is to clean all the rims off. They're all salted up now, and sometimes you get salt on the edge and there's fish on the edges and stuff like that. So you want to clean the rims off all nice. I just use paper towel, go around, wipe them all down good, make sure they're clean, get everything off it. And that just allows for a good seal. That rubber compound in your lid can seal nicely to that. If you got junk in there, it's not going to make a good seal. So make sure you clean them off real good, and yeah, then you'll be ready to put the lids on. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and place the lids on, and you just put them in, gently set them on. You don't have to push them on or anything like that, just set them on. Make sure those rims are nice and clean. And these lids, I just washed them. I didn't sterilize them or heat them up or anything. I just wash them off with warm soapy water, and that's all you really gotta do. Good thing I only did 24 jars because I only bought 24 lids, so perfect. So we're all set. Next is the rings. Sorry. And this, I just screw them on just till they're like snug. Like not even, just so they're making contact. Don't tighten them. If you tighten them, it'll be worse. So just snug is all you want to do. So get those lids on, just not even finger tight. Just so it kind of makes contact is what you want to do. So I've got all the fish in jars right now in the fridge because I have to go get the kids off the bus. And I'm not going to be able to actually can them until later tonight. So, but my video is just a pretty brief overview of everything that I do. If you want, after you've watched all the videos from this guy, then go over to publicresource.org and canning fish in jars. And this video is super detailed. It goes through all the safety and step by step, more so than what I did between the old guys in camp and this video here. This is how I learned how to do it. And it's really, really good resource, this one. So I'll put a link in the description to this video too. So I'm finally able to get the canning process started. So this is my big canner, and I'm going to do it outside on my Coleman. I like to do it with gas rather than my electric stove, just because it's a lot easier to control the heat. So I've got more jars here. And so I've got the first row down. The second row goes, you have to straddle the other jar. So it's sitting on the rims. Or sorry, on the rings. So yeah, you just want to straddle them, so they're not sitting on the actual lids themselves. So now I'm just heating it up. Get the water heated up, and then I'm gonna cook it like that Well, I'll get the lid on, I'll show you that. So there, I've got two rows of jars in, and they're all sitting again. Make sure they're sitting on the rings, not on the actual lids. So now I'm gonna get the lid on and start to warm it up. So yeah, I'm gonna put the lid on. Just gotta line up the arrows. So. And then slide it shut. So I'm just gonna let it cook for, well, as long as it takes, until there's steam coming out of here. And once the steam, sorry, I'll get in there. So once there's a steady stream coming out of here, I'm gonna let it steam for 10 minutes and then put on the weight. And once the weight goes on, then the pressure will start to come up. We need to get the pressure up and then maintain that pressure for 100 minutes. And if for some reason it gets underneath pressure or dips below where it's supposed to be, you have to start all over again. So this is where, once this weight goes on, that's when I really start to babysit this thing, because I don't want to start all over again, especially at this hour of the night. So I'm going to babysit it pretty good. So hopefully the steam will start soon, and then we can get the weight on it and bring up the pressure. So it's been heating for a while now. I can hear it boiling inside, and there's starting to be fairly steady steam coming out of the petcock, they call it. I'm gonna give it a few more minutes. Once it's a steady stream, then I'm gonna wait. I wait 10 more minutes of that, and then I put on the weight, and then the pressure will start to come up. So, 10 more minutes of this. But yeah, it's starting to steam good now. So we've been heating for a while now, probably 20 minutes or so. It's boiling good inside, you can hear it boiling. And now you can see a pretty steady stream of steam coming out the spout. It's hard to see it actually in the dark, but yeah, it's quite a bit coming out. So anyway, so now I have to wait 10 minutes of this steaming. So I let it steam for 10 minutes. And then once it's steamed for 10 minutes, then I'm going to put the weight on. And that will start to bring the pressure up. Right now we're still at zero. So 10 minutes. Okay, so it's been steaming good for over 10 minutes now, so time to put the weight on. And then now the pressure will start to climb. It does take a little while. We want to get it up to 12 pounds pressure. Really, you probably only have to do it at 11, but I just do it at 12, extra safety. So we'll wait for that to get up to pressure now. Getting close now. And there we go, 100 minutes is up. 100 minutes is up. Pressure's still up, quite a bit up actually. So all I do now is turn off the heat and let it cool down naturally. Do not try and open it or speed up the process at all. Just let it cool off naturally. So I'm just gonna shut it all down and go to bed and pull it apart in the morning. So it's morning, and I left them outside last night, so let's see how they turned out. So I just left it outside to cool off naturally last night. Harper thinks it smells good. Get out of there. Okay, so we'll bring it in, and we'll open up, see how many sealed and how many didn't. Take that off. There's no pressure left. So. Here we go. Smells fishy. Ooh, looks like we did pretty good. Looks like a lot of them are all sealed up, so. Still actually warm. Gotta get the foam. Okay, I'm back. So, looks like they turned out all right. See that one? Gotta check them. That one didn't seal. I don't know if you can see that, but I can. So that one didn't seal. So I actually had three that didn't seal, and because they're still warm and they haven't been out like for a long, long time and were pressurized most of the night, I'm just gonna put them in the fridge and use them up right away. You could put new lids on them and reseal them, like reprocess them with new lids, and hopefully they seal then. I'm not gonna bother, I'm just gonna use them up right away. But you could do that if you want. It doesn't affect it at all. They'll turn out just fine if you reprocess them, but I'm not gonna bother. So I'm gonna get these all packed away, and I'm going to come back and show you what I actually do with this canned whitefish. So now that the whitefish is all canned up, I'm just gonna show you what you can do with it. And you can do a lot of different things with it. Anything you would do with canned salmon or canned tuna, you can do with canned whitefish. But I'm just gonna show you what I do most often. I use it for lunches a lot, so this is what I do with it anyways. So I've opened the jar up, I've got it all drained. I drained most of the water off, but I don't drain it all off because a lot of the good omega fats are in the watery part. So I leave a little bit in there, but I just empty out the jar. Doesn't always look that appealing at first, but it is really good stuff, trust me. So I mix that all up. I've got some celery chopped up and lots of onion chopped up. And then I like black pepper. I like lots of black pepper too. And of course, everyone's favorite, roasted garlic and peppers. I don't do a ton of that, but just enough to give it a little flavor. This stuff's so good though. Now, normally I would use avocado. Normally I would put avocado in this. I'm trying to eat healthier, less mayo. Today I don't have an avocado, so I'm gonna do mayo. So just squirt in some mayo. And you just mix it all up. So there. Maybe it doesn't look that appealing, but it tastes really good. So then I'm gonna do a wrap with it. Probably don't do this quite right. Someone can probably leave in the comments how you're supposed to wrap these properly, but do that. I chopped up a little more onion. Ooh, lettuce. I forgot lettuce. Gotta have lettuce. Okay, let's go get some lettuce. Oh, here comes Harper. It's nice to have a stash right out the back door. Sorry. That should do it. All right. You think that's for you? Don't jump. You know better than that. Come on, Harper. All right. Yeah. So I got the lettuce all washed off, and I like to put lots of lettuce on. We always have a little patch at the back door there. It's kind of handy. So fold in the sides, flip over the top, roll it up, and that's it. Ready to go. Except for it's not that neat, but that's one of my favorite things to do for lunch. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it's helpful to you. And I hope maybe you can use some of these tips to can some fish. And yeah, just make good use of fish that are very abundant and very good for you as well. So I hope you enjoyed.